Okay, this is a 1907 Leyat Trainer. It was built by Marcel Leyat in 1907. This was a replica, actually. But he built this vehicle to train people how to fly an airplane before they actually got in an airplane and it took off. Marcel Leyat was born in Grenoble France in 1885, and he was educated in France as an engineer, and he worked for various aeronautical companies. He went on to build, in 1913, he built his first propeller-powered car. In 1919 to 1924, he built a production series of propeller-powered cars for about 25. And he also designed about 5 to 10 airplanes, and about half of those airplanes were built. But this is really one of the first things that he did. And the way it works is it was made to be towed behind a car, and a person would get in it, and they could turn. If they turn the wheel, the vehicle would bang. If they go forward or backwards, the tail goes up and down, and it would make the attitude go up and down on the vehicle like you're climbing or descending in an airplane. So there's this little carriage here that is hooked to a car, and it pulls the vehicle along at about 25 miles an hour. And the trainer sits on this ball, so it can swivel left and right, up and down, back and forth. So obviously, at dead stop, it's angled back like that. The tail here sits on the ground. It has these skids that drag along the ground until you get enough speed, and the tail will come up, and the airplane or the trainer will balance itself. And the ball is hooked to the vehicle right underneath the seat, right about where you sit. So, but the way we found out about this vehicle was when he found Leyat's drawings in the attic in Marceau about 5 years ago, drawings that had been up there since the 1940s. This was in that material, but the most amazing thing about this vehicle is the only information about this vehicle are these three pictures that we have here, which David's going to give you a little closer up, but there's three photographs of the vehicle. One of them is attached to a car. And so Mirko from the Czech Republic took these three photographs, and he basically scaled the height of the person in this one photograph and used that as a standard distance and figured everything else out from these three photographs. There were no drawings, there's no films,